protest, and that's why we're going to stay here. Because Thatcher's hands and Reagan's hands are bloodied with the blood of black people in South Africa. We have to take up the struggle here on behalf of black people in South Africa against Thatcher, against Reagan, against the racists. The black people of South Africa expect it of us.
We're going to win!
We're going to win!
Really, what our job in this country is to mobilise all the potential support, which there certainly is, for Nelson Mandela to come out of prison, and to make that very clear and very direct and very much on the streets that we demand the release of Nelson Mandela. This is what many people in Britain want, and in order to achieve that, we aim to get many people out there onto that picket line.
Do you foresee any circumstances under which you would talk with and release Nelson Mandela?
I'm only prepared to talk to people who want constitutional change, but I'm not prepared to talk to people who want revolutionary change.
If Mandela were to say that he wanted constitutional change...
He does not want it. He's stated it all over and over again, and he's in jail because he took certain steps which overstepped the mark as far as legislation was concerned.
You see him staying there?
I'm seeing him staying.
My father says, I cannot and will not give any undertaking at a time when I and you, the people, are not free. Your freedom and mine cannot be separated.
The first demand is for the release of Nelson Mandela. And there's an obvious reason for that. Mandela is not only the leader of the South African people, he's also refused to accept that his freedom is separate from the freedom of the South African people as a whole. There are masses of people in South Africa calling for his release, countries all around the world calling for his release, and we believe that that call has to be made in Britain and made very strongly. The second demand is for the release of all South African political prisoners. Mandela himself wouldn't see his role as a prisoner and as a leader as separate from the many, many black people who fought against apartheid, who are being held in apartheid jails. So we're calling for the release of all South African political prisoners as well as Nelson Mandela. The third demand is for the closing down of the South African embassy in Britain.
The support which the picket has had was started with a demonstration on Saturday. We decided to launch the picket with a big demonstration, and that proved the fact that many people from different walks of life, there were as a vicar from the Church of England, there was a Labour councillor, Sharon Atkin, from Black Sections, there were communists, anarchists, socialists, liberals, young people, old people, many different people.
Comrades, we have a debt to pay the people of South Africa, and that is freedom for them all. And unless we smash that vile fascist regime, we cannot sleep easily in our beds. So we must support this fight. We must support this picket. We must bring thousands of people out to Trafalgar Square until every prisoner is released and every black person in South Africa, Azania, is free.
I think you have to show that you disapprove of apartheid. The more South Africa is isolated, the more the message might get through.
We've situation. We've asked for them to come in for assembly.
Oh, right.
And someone to talk. So if you'd like to come in, we'll arrange it. If that is
What school?
From about 11 o'clock onwards, there was still about 60 to 70 people. And by 3 a.m., there were still 30 people. Mm. And at that time, there were still people who had seen the demonstration earlier in the day who came to visit the picket in the middle of the night for a short time. Yeah. So it was still going quite well.
And, you know, yesterday what was striking on the demonstration when we marched from Midborough Street in King's Cross to here, the amount of Barclays banks that we actually walked past and the way people feel about investments from Barclays Bank. And I mean, basically, it's not that Barclays Bank are the only bank that invests in South Africa, but they are the biggest investor single bank in South Africa, and they represent a vast proportion of wealth that's been drawn from the South African economy purely by investing money from this country. So they don't actually contribute a single thing to help the black people of South Africa, but yet they're willing to exploit profits from their sufferings.
Profits for this government and for the British capitalist class count for everything. What is happening in South Africa only concerns them insofar as they can continue to make profits and defend their profits. They're not really concerned what is happening to the people of South Africa. So it's up to us, really. We have to build the protest movement that will force the British government to move, because it has no choice, because the pressure here is so great that it has to move.
South Africa, everybody uses black and white. Try to draw the line between wrong and right, but if you use your eyes to really see, you know we don't see realistically. Because skin that's black is really painful. Either you can't see or I can't think. Skin that's black is really brown, but that don't make the world go round. To put a color on skin, to me it's a sin. That's why apartheid must never win. We must put an end to this, my friend, and it should never be allowed to happen again. It's time to wake up and do some good. To try to see each other the way we should. Because looking at the people, I sometimes find that Sun City is in the mind.
A leader of the Soweto community has sent us this message. Right, straight from Soweto, right? We have heard the work of Citigroup for a long time now, and of the criticisms against you. But you have shown what fine stuff you are made of. What we here have always known since the 86-day picket. We greet the British people who are prepared to stand shoulder to shoulder with us and look forward to your news. Please pass the greetings of the people of Soweto to the Non-Stop Picket to release Nelson Mandela.
For over three centuries, our people have been oppressed politically. They have no voice in the running of their affairs. Our people have been exploited economically, despite the wealth which races of Africa is renowned about. Our people have no stake in the economy of that country. For over three centuries, our people have been degraded socially. It is precisely for this reason that you have seen this build up among the struggling masses in racist South Africa.
A leader of the ANC in South Africa has sent us this message. Woo! I have always known that you are with us. This action, you can tell it's by a woman. This action planned for the 19th of April is the most magnificent demonstration of your group in response to our call, and it will never be forgotten. We hope you will manage to withstand the cold and the rain and all the other things you come up against. Hey. Never forget that our children, our people, are withstanding detention and torture, imprisonment and murder, st- starvation and bullets. May nothing deter you. We are watching you and standing with you. Forward, forward. Or as we say, Amandla!
Now listen, we hear a lot about violence in this country. The British press, the most despicable press in the world, is always going on about violence. You know something? The ruling class in this country is terrified of one sort of violence. It's terrified of the violence of the oppressed peoples of this world fighting for justice, for freedom and democracy.
Those men who dig potatoes for the white farmer and who get kicked to their death, if need be one day, they will be the first to pick up their arms. When one day the revolution will be internal, they will be the first to pick up their arms. That is how angry they are. It's like keeping a lid on a kettle that has been boiling for years. The day that kettle explodes, Vietnam will have been a picnic.
Kill all those people then.
As now, well, let me put that to
you. We have guns, but we have no bullets.
Fighting on the streets and who are being murdered by the police, all our organisations, everybody who gives voice to what they want are saying that those people who are struggling and fighting for freedom and for human rights and democracy want other people throughout the world to join them in their struggle. What we're doing is being present on the streets of London, making the call that the people of South Africa are asking for. Citigroup has had a lot of experience of the British police and the way that they treat demonstrators. I think our experience is probably pretty much on a par with most political demonstrators in Britain. But what we do is we always defend people who've been arrested. We campaign when the police attempt to take away our rights. And it's a very important part of what we do, because what we're saying is that we also want freedom in Britain. We want freedom in South Africa, and we want to support the people who are fighting for freedom in South Africa. But we also stand for our own democratic rights in Britain.
We're surrounded! We're caged in! We've got barriers around us. We've got policemen on either side. Why are they there? Do you honestly think that these policemen here are defending law and order? Do you think they are the upholders of law and order? Well, let me tell you, the Metropolitan Police are the biggest threat to law and order in this country.
The police attack black picketers, like, first, and very, very viciously. We found in doing anti-apartheid work in this country that you just can't separate the question of racism in Britain and fighting apartheid in South Africa. Therefore, you know, the two struggles are actually inseparable, and it's a very strong message that is made time and time again on the picket that, you know, we're not only standing there in solidarity with black people in South Africa,
fighting against apartheid oppression, but we're also fighting against racism in this country.
Release Mandela, cause him lead us best. Isolate the positive and free all the rest of Senna.
Hey, 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 hey. We're coming out and picking up, we're feeling irate. We're Irie, Irie in a fashion and a star, cause we're well, wicked and we're well, wild.
Take advantage of the people who are fighting the good fight in South Africa and who are present at this picket here, is that you are all young and the future is in your hands. And one of the things you are going to do with your hands is to make Africa free.
So our strength is in our numbers on the streets. Our strength is in massive campaigns, open democratic campaigns. We must build this picket. We must lift the movement against apartheid in this country. We can do it if all of you organise to be here day in, day out, until Nelson Mandela is free. Free! Free Nelson Mandela! Free all South African political prisoners! Close down this racist embassy!
And a non-stop picket of the embassy.
Till the Bota regime.
Till the Bota regime lifts the ban. We'll do all we can. So lend a helping hand.
Non-stop again.
Oh, non-stop Mandela. You are leader in your chosen home. Oh, non-stop Mandela.
You are a force.
You are a force.
Till the water regime lifts the ban, we'll do all we can to lend a helping hand. Holy Tata,
Holy Tata Mandela.
The freedom fighters,
fighters are inspired by you. Holy Tata Mandela, you are a living hero to the youth.
Embassy, and we